Well, we got a big show today.
Wow.
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 Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah. Your 22nd favorite podcast is back with another episode. They swore that they'd try to bring you quality product this week, but they failed miserably. It's time for Balls Out with Ben Glaze and Brett Hayes.
Good afternoon.
Yeah, do it. Maybe some of this Rolling Rock.
You want to see a magic trick?
You want to see a magic trick?
Aye.
Programming note, we're going to do next week's episode.
Yes.
With post-show talk.
Correct.
And then the week after, we were going to do two episodes.
Yes.
Next week. But
or today.
Or today.
I had news stories that were like evergreen, where they weren't like super
specific.
Topical.
Right.
It's like, oh, we need to talk about that now.
But we figured it'd be more beneficial to do just the show on Thursday. So we'll record it Thursday.
Yeah.
The week after, and it won't be released until that night or
yeah,
the
patrons will
morning.
Get it. Patrons will get it Friday.
Cool.
Instead of Thursday.
Cool.
And you'll be able to talk about your Seattle trip.
Yeah, baby.
So that'll be fun.
Yeah. Speaking of, somebody posted on the Reddit in response to something that you posted yesterday.
Yeah.
And then I responded to you as well about that. Let me see. What did you post? We can just say that.
I shared, it was a news story. I just posted like a screen grab of it. Oh, a professor says magic mushrooms could replace antidepressants.
Yes.
And the funny thing about that is with listening to podcasts over the years, I've heard multiple people on podcasts say, oh, I had depression, took magic mushrooms.
Mm-hmm.
Either it went away,
right,
or it helped way better than antidepressants.
Yeah, I've heard that a lot, too. It opens your third eye. For sure. Have you ever done it?
I just wish it would open your brown eye.
That's right, Wade.
Jesus. No, I've never
Have you ever done any psychedelics?
No, the only thing I've done is smoked marijuana.
Oh, marijuana.
Yes.
I've done psychedelics.
Of course you have.
Of course I have. The first time I didn't.
From the bong.
Well, that, obviously. That's not a psychedelic, though.
First
time I did shrooms, I didn't think I had a depression problem, so I wouldn't have been able to tell. But
okay.
It was probably the funnest trip I've ever had.
Nice.
I was so happy, like, the whole time. It makes you so fucking giggly. And, oh, God. Speaking of. So, I did it with my buddy. did shrooms, went out into the woods. And then I ended up we were getting bitten up by mosquitoes. Like, he just wanted to go into the random-ass woods, into the swamp or something like that. Plus, we didn't have any toilet paper, and I had to shit really bad. So, tripping on shrooms, I drove
us. Your buddy's hand.
I drove us to a different park about 10 miles away.
Do they have bathrooms?
Yes.
Okay.
That was a trip. And it was like
a trip? Yeah. Within a trip?
Tripception.
Hiya!
Ended up getting lost in the woods at this other park that him and I were at. And then I ended up driving us back to my house once we found my car. All while I'm tripping, and I get home and my parents are home. So me and my buddy go up into my room and we're watching South Park and just like cracking up at every little thing.
Of course.
Even though it's not funny. Like, I mean, most of their shit's funny, but
it's
like
hilarious.
Like, we could not stop laughing. We had to like hush ourselves so that my parents can hear us. And we'd go downstairs. Me and my buddy Caleb would go smoke a cigarette. And my dad would come out and be like, hey, what you guys doing?
Okay.
And I'm like looking at Caleb and he's trying not to crack up at absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
So I'm like, just don't say anything, Caleb. And I'm like trying to keep a straight face because I know how to act around my parents. And it was the craziest fucking thing in the world. I'll say that.
Yeah, I smoked with a buddy of mine that I've known since like third grade. We had to have been in high school. We got super high right outside of his house in the backyard. Went in to the basement to watch movies or whatever.
Yeah.
And we were doing, it was just like with you, but his parents came downstairs.
Ooh.
and they started talking to us, and his mom was like, you guys are high. And his dad was like, no, they're not. And we were like, no, we're not. And then his dad would say something funny, and we would over laugh. And we just kept trying to convince her that we weren't high. Pretty sure his dad knew.
When was the last time you got high? Long time ago?
Yeah. It was at a Dave concert. Got so...
a Dave concert?
Yeah. So...
Dave Matthews?
Yeah. When you tailgate... I don't have Pooh Bus on here.
No.
Last time I inserted it.
Yeah, it was great.
Dick joke. Not really. So I smoked before we went in. I took a couple hits of something, and it was from these guys we know from Chicago.
This is at your buddies?
Yeah. No, wait, what? No, this is at a Dave concert while we're tailgating.
Yeah, Dave. Why don't you say Dave Matthews?
Okay. Dave Matthews concert.
There's no band named Dave.
And so we're drinking. Normally we just drink, but this day it was like 110 degrees. And so we were in between each beer, you're drinking the water, so you don't get a buzz.
Right.
And so I smoked, took a couple hits, and I got the perfect buzz as we're walking into the concert. It reminded me of high school when you would have shitty weed. Or at least not shitty weed, but nothing was like good.
I never smoked weed in high school.
Like...
It's not like the weed that is out there today. Where it's crystally. It's rad.
Back in high school, smoking
Mexican dirt.
Back in high school, smoking weed was like drinking beer. You could smoke to where you got to a good buzz and stop. Or you could get too fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's like depending on what you smoke. Like me, somebody who doesn't smoke very often, one hit and I'm super stoned. Right. But so we get into the concert, and this is the second night we see him. And the first night we kept talking about smoking during the show, like, oh, this song would be a good time to light up, or this song would be. And so my buddy brought some weed in the second night, some two joints, and we smoke one, and everything... okay.
Right.
And then he out of nowhere lights up the second one. And I'm like, dude, like that's no.
Yeah, I'll pass.
No, but then he passed. And we kept going. And then it got to a point where we're laughing nonstop.
At the concert.
Yeah. I look behind me for some reason and realize there is a giant like area, like a circle, probably like 20 feet by 20 feet.
Like the audio production booth or something?
No, it's just the lawn where nobody's standing.
Oh, okay.
Whoever was there left.
Right.
And I go to my buddy. I'm like, don't step back. There's a giant hole behind us and I don't want you to fall in. Because like the ground was just pitch black, like dark.
Yeah, it was a night concert.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so that's happening. And then all of a sudden I'm like, dude, I think I shit my pants.
God, that took a turn for the worst.
And my buddy looked, all of a sudden the happy-go-luckiness left his face.
Oh, God.
And he goes, I think I shit my pants too.
What?
And so then me and him were like... What if the reason why there's nobody behind us is because we shit our pants and we smell so bad they all left? And then
so you're like paranoid about your shit now?
Yeah. Turns out neither of us shit our pants.
Okay, good.
And the weed we smoked was called Alaskan Thunderfuck.
I think I've smoked that.
And I didn't like. I understand that stuff nowadays has crazy names, and I wasn't sure if I should believe them, but then all of a sudden I saw it like in a TV show or in a movie, and I was like, okay, that is a strand
I never pay attention to strands or anything like that, but the reason I do that is because every strand has different effects, obviously. So
yeah,
there's indica, sativas, indica couch, sativa
indica couch,
the opposite. So it's more energetic weed, so I think that's just how they differentiate them. But I've never been to a dispensary, but when I'm out in Seattle, I'm going to stop
it. Of course.
Fuck yeah, dude.
I wouldn't put it past
you. I'm going to be out there Friday to Wednesday.
So. And you're going
to
be stoned the whole time.
The whole time. And yep.
Are you going to try to sneak stuff back on the plane?
Maybe like a couple edibles.
Oh, okay.
Other than that, I'm just going to U.S. Postal.
Oh, really?
I'm going to shit myself, yeah, because they need a federal warrant to check that stuff. So.
Ah, so you better tell your parents they need that, too.
Yeah, exactly. So
they're committing a crime if they open that.
No, I'm going to send it back the day that I leave. And
hopefully I wonder if the package will smell.
No, I'm going to wrap it somehow. My buddy's done it before. So.
Okay.
Back to the mushrooms thing.
Yeah.
Here's what Ben Richards in 1987 said on Reddit. I was happy to see Ben's tweet about psilocybin being a potential treatment for depression. Everyone should at least read up on it. I know it sounds crazy and that they're not for everyone, but mushrooms really will alter the course of humanity for the better. I agree with him.
Humanity.
Yeah, I would suggest...
World peace.
Well, not everybody's going to do it, but...
World peace.
If more people did it, then they'd see it. I would suggest to Ben that recording a podcast during your first time taking them might not be the best idea. Oh, he's thinking you're actually going to take them? It's easy to spin out when you're thinking about how you're being perceived by other people. Yes, definitely. You get very paranoid.
I should do it this weekend. This weekend is Shroom Fest.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Ari Shaffir puts it on every year.
Okay.
He suggests that you only do it once a year.
Yeah, that's what I agree. That, if you're going to trip at all, do shrooms once or acid once.
Dude, if anybody's thinking about doing this, if you go to, what is it? It's arithegreat.com.
Yeah, he. If you go to our Reddit, reddit.com/glazeandhaze, it's the post called Mushrooms. He actually posted the link as well. It's arithegreat.com.
Yeah. It's Ari Shaffir's website, and he...
Oh, yeah, Shroomfest.
Yeah, it's a link, right, called Shroomfest? Okay. Yeah.
Slash Shroomfest Primer.
He has this... It's a lot of information. Like, he goes, he tells you everything you need to know. Mm-hmm. And so if I ever do it, I'm going to, I guess, go off that. And he says that one of the big things is if you start tripping too hard, he says to drink milk because it lines your stomach and soaks it up.
And if you want to trip harder, he says orange juice.
Yeah, he said orange juice or smoke a joint.
Oh,
like if you start coming down or coming out of your trip and he says you want to amp it right back up. Yeah.
Man.
But what I don't like is the fact that he says on a minor one, it'll be like 3 to 6 hours.
Oh, easily. I wouldn't even say three. I think 6 to 8 hours. Eight to ten if you're really, really good shit.
Such a long time.
Well, you need to make an afternoon out of it or a whole day out of it. But Ben here makes a good point in his last couple sentences.
Not Ben Glaze, okay, Ben Richards.
Ben Richards, Ben Dickards.
Ah, Richards. Didn't that guy say the N-word on stage?
I don't care. He makes a good point here saying spend the day outside with your best friends and don't worry about any responsibilities. Maybe on a weekend can be trip or something. And for anyone who's thinking about trying, Ari Shaffir.
I don't know if I trust my friends because Ari put in there, don't do it with people that are going to like make you laugh and try to fuck with you.
Well,
so like
depends. They know you're tripping. Like I've done it around. My friends are the only people I ever do it around.
Okay,
and I know that they won't fuck with me. So you have to do it with somebody you trust.
Yeah,
you have to be not around technology,
right?
Because technology's a bitch.
He said, have like a ton of like notebooks and pens so you can write down anything that comes to your mind.
When my buddy Caleb and I did it, he had a notebook. He was like drawing.
Okay.
Just coloring or...
I wonder if I could come up with any good stand-up bits.
I fucking guarantee you could.
Maybe I'll have, like, my first funny joke.
Soft serve dick. But if you ever do it, I want to be there. Cause
you won't fuck with me?
No, I won't fuck with you. No, I've been in the situation.
That's what I'm worried about.
You don't
about.
Want a bad trip.
Because
it's all about your mindset going into it. If you have you're like, okay, it's going to be really
good.
You're
going to embrace it? Yeah.
Yeah. If you're scared and you're like, okay, these guys are going to fuck with me, you're probably going to have a bad trip. Yeah.
What if you drink a shit ton of milk? Will you come out of it a lot quicker?
No. You won't come out of it a lot quicker. It might bring
just the
you
effects
down.
Won't.
I've never
be
tried
as strong.
Milk because I've always wanted to get higher. So.
Oh.
But orange juice has always worked, and smoking a joint will get you higher for sure.
Well, yeah. But same thing when you like drink beer.
Speaking of, I'm going to be doing that in Seattle.
What?
Shrooms.
Oh, geez.
So I'll be able to be doing a lot. Talk about that when I get back.
You're going to die.
No, I'm not going to die. You know, if you do get caught selling mushrooms, it's a manslaughter charge.
What?
Yeah.
But you can't, you're not killing anybody.
No,
it's the same thing with pot. I think Ari said you can't die from, like, you can't, like.
You can't die from shrooms, but it is, the reason you trip is because you're poisoning yourself.
Okay.
So you get a manslaughter charge if you're caught selling. I worked with a guy who actually got in trouble at a concert or something, like Bonnaroo or something, selling shrooms. He got busted.
Do you get that big of a charge for selling other drugs? Like heroin or something?
Depends on the drug. Not weed, because it won't kill you. Heroin, yeah.
Yeah, but shrooms won't kill you.
It could. It could poison.
You think?
It poisons you. You're deliberately poisoning somebody. Let me find some more information on this.
This is the shroom cast.
No, this is good talk, though. Like, this is the first time we've actually, like, had a...
Oh, yeah, that is true. Instead of just fucking around
it's
the whole time.
Not the first time, but...
Not the funnest podcast, but...
No, it is.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Because, like, the reason, like, I thought about doing this stuff, and there's also, they're testing ketamine.
Yeah, I've got a story about that, too.
Which, both drugs that I guess are taboo, but seem to be helping depression.
Uh-huh.
And it's also, like, I think it's, like, for ketamine, it's, like, once a month.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know how long it's going to take until that's actually, like, something that can be prescribed. But they're seeing lots of good things coming out of both things.
Yeah.
Where it's like, me, I tried pills, all these different types of medications for years. And now, finally, within the last year, I've been put on a couple things that are actually working.
Yeah. What are you taking, if you don't mind me asking?
It's Lexapro and Lamictal.
Okay, I've heard of those.
Yeah. Good stuff.
So, off of ketamine.
Yeah.
When I dated Lily.
Okay.
She was...
Lily.
Yeah.
Brittany. Thanks. Anne. Pam.
Yeah. Sorry. And... She was like, we
you
were
merely adopted the trip. She was born in it.
Severely depressed.
Okay.
And she actually tried the ketamine treatment.
Okay.
And it was very strange because it's not FDA approved. They're working on getting it approved.
How was she able to do it? Was she
there's
like
a guy out
test subject?
Kind of. Nah, not really. But, I mean, it's perfectly legal to do. It's just not, they haven't gone through all the mumbo jumbo of getting it approved.
It's legal to do?
Yeah. But it's...
Here? Like you said, she went somewhere.
Yeah, she went into Granville right by the...
Oh, so here.
Yeah, the Metro Health offices.
Okay.
This is probably about a year ago, and I took her because she can't drive home.
Yeah.
And it was just a guy who was just starting up his doctor's business or whatever, and he was actually on West 8. I can find you the clip, and he talks about it. And
find me this guy.
I will. I'll find it.
Try it out.
But she tried it out.
Your mom's house.
And she said it actually worked. Tom's it was girl. Very weird because I left.
Christina
he took her into a room, did an intravenous.
Intravenous?
Drip. Ketamine drip or whatever.
Yeah.
And I come back an hour later, walk into the dark room, and she's just, like, totally out of it. And she said that, like, after 2 weeks after, it actually helped her. And it was monthly treatments, but it was
it's really expensive. Yeah.
Then that's why the FDA thing is so crucial, because it's not approved. That's why insurance won't cover
right.
it.
Right.
So
do you know how expensive?
I think she paid a grand.
Oh, I'm not doing that.
Or it was between $500 and $1,000
Jesus
per session.
Christ.
I think it was $500 for a session.
Yeah, there's no way.
But if I were you, I'd try CBD. Because that stuff is coming out more often in stores. There's one up on Plainfield that sells it. Even Z's liquor store downtown, they have it there.
My girlfriend tried it for she has like body aches. I feel like she has fibromyalgia. Mm-hmm. If you've ever heard Freebeer talk about his wife, she has it. And my girlfriend has like the exact same symptoms.
Right. Is that bones? Or muscle?
She's sore. She has restless legs, like bad. She'll lift her leg up and then slam it down, or she'll kick me all night.
I get that at nighttime.
She's always like fatigued. Like I'm always tired, but she's like way worse.
Right. She probably works harder than you.
Yeah, that's true. And fucks more.
You're welcome.
Oh, yeah. Thank you for taking care of that for me. Stop ruining my jokes. What were we talking about? CBD boy.
CBD boy.
Yeah. She tried it for that stuff, and it didn't work.
No?
No, not at all.
Oh, maybe it depends on milligrams.
Because like I've heard comedian Sam Morril, he takes it for his back pain.
Yeah.
And it works.
No.
And I would be fine with that, because like, the THC's...
Yeah, you don't get high.
All out of it.
It does all the things weed would do.
I can't believe they're able to separate it like that.
I know. It's because it doesn't get you high. I'll bring some in next week. I've tried it before, and it has helped my depression. Like, legit.
Why don't you do it, like, all the time, then?
Just because I was having to go to Lansing to buy it.
Oh, okay.
And it just became, like, legal here. So I just haven't gone out of my way to... find a place that sells it.
Okay.
But are we recording?
Oh, yeah.
How bad would that be?
It wouldn't be so bad. It would just be, well, we lost a conversation.
That was good content.
I hope so.
I hope so. Oh, we had a Vandy quote from last week that we never read.
Really?
Yeah.
Where do you see these?
On our Patreon?
I looked on there. There's Max has a great post on there.
Yes, he does. We'll go through that. Best quote from 2 weeks ago. I've always wanted to suck a dick. Well, my dick, Brett Hayes.
Thanks, Vandy.
Yeah.
Hey.
should I read Max's?
I like people who are idiots.
Should I read Max's story?
Yes, please.
Ooh, this is.
Okay. I want to know if you've ever done this.
Yes, I have.
I have a small thing where I did this. It wasn't your as dick? Bad as this. Oh. Good one.
Good one. All right. He says, texting the wrong person. This happened about 4 years ago. I worked with a guy named Dave. Dave. And one day, Dave had been sent into the office and was getting fired. Meanwhile, I sent a text to my girlfriend, Dave. Oh, Vandy.
Was it a dirty one?
Yeah. He says, I think I finally got Dave fired.
What?
Well,
I thought he was going to say, like, I think I finally got you pregnant.
No. He says, well, turns out I didn't text my girlfriend.
I finally can come out as gay. I just realized how hot Dave is.
Good first 20 minutes, and then you just start interrupting.
Well, we went from serious to joking.
We don't have to cut each other off the whole time.
All right, so Dave was getting fired.
Well, turns out I didn't text my girlfriend. I sent the message to him.
Oh, no.
Dave was buff and also bipolar.
Dave was buff.
And he gave me the death stare as he walked out of the shop with all his things. Dave and I haven't spoken since. Dave would probably murder me if we saw each other. Moral of the story, double check the recipient before you hit send.
Yes.
And most importantly, fuck Dave. Also, Max, I want to know how you got Dave fired. Please tell me that.
Yeah, exactly. When he said fuck Dave, the first thing I thought of was you saying fuck Justin.
Oh, fuck him, too. He's a fucking ass.
And when he gave him the death stare, I wonder if it was just... It could be like, oh, I'm going to kill you, or it could have been, oh, I'm going to kill myself. I mean, he is or bipolar like,
hey,
after
I just
all.
Got fired. Man.
Yeah,
no,
I doubt your manager would have told him that you were the reason. But yeah, I have done that before.
Even if you weren't the reason, saying that or sending that text, then he obviously is going to think you're the reason.
Oh, yeah,
reason
I forgot that he
it.
Sent it to him.
Yeah. So what was your...
right over my head.
What was your situation?
I was riding in my in the car with my parents to...
Riding on cars with toys.
Yeah.
Nice reference.
And we were going to some family function, and the night before I had... I was super drunk and probably, yeah, I was super stoned. And I thought I was texting one of my buddies, Tyler, who I'm going out to see in Seattle, actually. And I said, oh, dude, I got so fucked up.
Tyler, is Tyler black?
No, he's white.
Oh, of course.
It's I said, I got so fucking high last night, something like that.
Yeah.
And I sent it, and then I saw my dad's phone vibrate. And I look at my phone, and I sent it to him, and I'm like, oh, Dad, don't read that. So I grabbed for his phone, and luckily I deleted it.
Seriously?
Before he saw it, yeah.
Did he question you?
Yeah, he did.
And what did you say?
I was like, ah, oh, nothing. Just sent you a text I meant to send to somebody else. He didn't see it, so.
He had to have known it was bad the way you reacted.
Obviously, but yeah. You know, never went further than that.
Mine was.
All right, next story.
I was sitting in the basement at my buddy's house. We were all watching football and getting shit faced. And there was a post, like a beer poster.
Oh, shoot.
There's a beer poster with a like a hot chick dressed as Pocahontas.
Oh, fuck me.
And my girlfriend at the time, like, if she would have dressed in that same outfit,
you
she would have
fucked her.
Looked just like the chick on the poster. So I took a picture of the photo and I sent a text and said it was something along the lines of we should get you this outfit. You should wear this. Luckily, that's all I said because I realized I sent it to my dad.
Oh,
and sexy. So then I followed it up with sorry, wrong person. That was a Halloween costume idea for my girlfriend.
Oh, my God.
So, I mean, it was kind of quick thinking, but
what did he say? Anything?
I don't remember. I don't think he. I don't think he said anything.
Oh my Lord!
But I think me being quick enough with that second text,
you're quick,
maybe saved me.
Yeah,
but otherwise,
oh, this is awkward.
Man. Role play.
Yeah.
I mean, the next time I saw my dad, he called me John Smith, but.
You're funny.
Boo!
Excuse me.
You want to get to some news?
Yeah, I'm trying to find that, that segment about ketamine.
I've got some great news, dude.
I have actually tried ketamine, too.
And?
Yeah, it worked for a little while.
It paid a grand for it?
No. So when she went,
She took the IV and like got it into a water bottle and then you
No, you get the IV and then you also get a prescription for a nose spray. Like it's like Flonase.
Okay.
You spray it up into your nose and it gets you like oddly high.
Huh. Interesting.
So, yeah.
Huh. It's like the worst response you can get to anything.
Yeah.
Huh.
Okay, here, give me that audio.
Oh.
I just
no, it's here.
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
Oh, what are you plugged into then?
My dude, I'm plugged in the way I'm always plugged in. I know how this shit works.
Yeah. You need another beer yet?
No, I've got a 25 ouncer.
Okay.
This can't. I mean, it's like a perfect representation of my dick.
Okay. What?
It's like a perfect representation of my dick.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Do you want to listen to this?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Millions of Americans every year. And for those suffering, finding relief can be difficult. So today we're talking about a new treatment option with Nick Kolosch, board certified nurse anesthetist.
This guy's sexy too. I met him in person.
Clinic.
Seriously?
Thank you so much. So let's talk about what.
Jesus,
this
he looks
exactly
like Ryan Gosling.
Is.
He's fucking hot.
Basically, this is a new and exciting alternative to treating mood disorders such as depression, anxiety, post-traumatic stress disorder, even certain chronic pain issues for those patients who are treatment resistant to the current medications offered today.
Okay, he's hot, but he needs to be less boring.
Yes, this is a medication. It is given intravenously, so it's an infusion.
That's very cool.
That works pretty much by intravenous infusion given at a sub-anesthetic dose over a certain amount of time, depending on the diagnosis.
Wish you would have said inner penis.
In a nutshell, that would mean we're giving ketamine through an IV at a very low dose so that the patient's still awake.
Very low dose.
It provides these positive effects as far as treating their symptoms.
Really, this is really boring.
FDA approved for this specific use yet, but you've had a lot of opportunity to.
This guy shouldn't be talking. He should make be fucking in a porno.
Who had great success in utilizing this?
Yes, correct. Actually, ketamine is an FDA-approved medication.
What?
As an anesthetic, however, to treat these specific.
As an anesthetic.
Is brand new, and it's kind of going through the process of becoming FDA-approved. So hopefully in the future that'll happen, and that should allow things to happen as far as having insurance coverage and benefiting more patients overall.
Who would be a good candidate for this kind of treatment?
Like I was saying earlier, those who are resistant to the current medications as far as compression. Anxiety,
Snowflake, you're the one who was complaining about me talking. Making jokes and playing drops. Now you fucked up the audio.
Yeah.
Good afternoon!
Your cat, your cat distracted me.
Oh, did he put his paw underneath the door?
Yeah.
I saw comedian Pete Lee over the weekend.
I'm so pissed.
That you didn't see him?
Yes, because I was going to ask you if you wanted to go.
Okay.
And then I saw he was in town on Friday. And
why didn't you go? I went and saw him Saturday
I just didn't think about it. I just didn't think to go. I thought about it like Thursday or Friday morning when I saw that he was at the radio station. I'm like, I fucking love that guy. He's so funny.
Yeah.
He's great.
Well, the reason I thought of it, because he had a joke about being on the shitter and the cat putting its paw underneath the door.
Yeah.
But yeah, when I was at Adam Sandler, speaking, that's how the idea came up. We were just, me and my girlfriend were hanging out before the show, and she's like, do you want to go see, I said, I wonder how Pete Lee's like audience is tonight because of the Adam Sandler show. She's like, how about we go see him on Saturday? And I was like, fuck yeah. All
right.
I got to move the phone thing. It's fucking with the... there we go. Make it a buzzing. Adam Sandler was the shit.
Was he?
Have you seen his Netflix special?
Nope.
Okay.
Did you ever sell your tickets?
I sold one pair, and then I basically gave the other pair for $50 to somebody who won their tickets from LAV.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I upgraded them from like the top row of the nosebleeds down to like halfway through the floor.
So nice of you.
Yeah.
Wow.
Dude.
Fucking bitch. What?
You need to watch his special on Netflix.
No. I won't do it because you won't watch a 10-minute fucking show for me.
For robots and, I don't know, anime.
It's not anime. You're a bitch.
Love, sex, and robots.
There you go.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah. Love, death, and robots.
Ah. Uh-huh. I just, made
you
up the
cock problem over there.
Yeah, I got
itchy
scrotum.
Really grabbing, man.
I've heard Anthony Cumia talk about how women will never have the...
Cumia with an O or are you?
The joy of being able to do the pinch and roll.
Oh, man.
With your scrotum.
Yeah, it is great.
Yeah.
Well, they don't have scrotums, so.
Right. That's what I'm saying. They'll never experience that.
Maybe they could do it with their lips.
I know. Yeah. Somebody who really has some meat curtains.
And.
Oh, shut up, Tony.
Let that pot out.
Oh, Bill told me I should do a podcast with Travis.
You guys should call it The Producers. You guys could talk sports and stuff. I'm like, yeah, great. I knew him.
I've always thought about the three of us.
Yeah, that'd be great, I think. But
because you had talked about him being a guest.
Yeah. Do you have another mic?
I do.
Well,
I have two other mics. And
we got to get him in here.
Finagle all this.
On a Wednesday.
I feel like three people would be better.
I think that you and I are great.
Oh, I know that.
But he can join us once he listens to all 38 episodes.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, okay, we need to do something. Maybe we'll bring him in for the 50th.
Ooh.
Because I feel like we need to do something special for the 50th.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
probably something real
special. I have, I don't know when it'll be, but I have July 25th through the 27th off.
Yeah.
And so I was hoping we could record a couple stunts.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Like the one word challenge. Yeah, that'll be an easy
totally
one.
Totally down with that.
Yeah.
I'm so down, Bean.
You ready for this?
No. I'm not ready. 3, 2, 1, go.
From WPRN, it's time for Channel 11 News with Buster Cummings and Johnny Something on the spot. If they've read about it, you'll hear about it. Hold on to your butts, because it's time. Here's the fucking news.
Yes. Thanks, Gilbert.
He really struggled getting through that, man.
Yes, and but it's yes also, and yes. It makes it better.
Oh, it's great. I'm not here, saying it's not great.
Shock me before we get started.
Oh, yeah? Why? What'd you do, Ben?
Huh? Oh!
Ooh, I want to do it now. Beeper. I feel like I have to.
I saw it here on the table when I was bringing in all the newspapers, and I was like, I should shock myself. I'm kind of addicted to that feeling now. Dude, you've been doing it for like 20 times and you're not getting anything.
No, maybe it's dead.
Oh, it's definitely not. Come on. What the hell is going on?
I'm pulling on it, man. Oh, okay, there it is.
I was going to say, pull harder.
All right, you can find me on Reddit.
That's what she said.
You can find me on Twitter at glazeandhaze.twitter.com.
We haven't even gotten to the news. Let's see.
Oh, that went right in the trash.
Okay, this is fucked up. There's a woman named Sarette Emke in Pennsylvania.
Stupid name.
And she and her family were recently eating at Golden Corral Buffet when the manager kicked her out. He said she was dressed, quote, too provocatively. And some other people complained. So what was she wearing?
Nothing, hopefully.
She was kind enough to take a bathroom selfie of her outfit.
You have a picture?
Yes, I do.
You do?
I can't wait to show you.
Oh god,
because it's not what I was expecting.
I'm so hard.
Selfie. I'm guessing, I forgot. Oh, it's a crop top that shows a lot of cleavage and a little bit of her stomach. Mmm. Abs. And some cut-off denim shorts. Ooh, yeah. Daisy Dukes. I'm guessing it was the ample cleavage that drew the attention. Of course.
Breasts.
She wrote on Facebook she thinks people had an issue with a small amount of her stomach that was showing because she's, quote, I don't know if I should read this.
Oh, I already know how it's going to end.
Ah, damn it. But I wanted you to see the picture.
Well, then show me the picture first.
All right. You can read the quote.
Oh, gosh. You have any whale drops?
Oh, yeah. That's what she sounded like in the bathroom after she took that selfie. God.
Okay, where's this quote at?
It's like two lines above the picture.
Oh. She wrote on Facebook she thinks people had an issue with the small amount of her stomach that was showing because she's, quote, not thin, so it's not considered sexy.
Rowan. Nobody will get that reference besides us.
Nope.
Oh, God.
That girl wears so much short clothes.
Seriously?
Oh, my God. Oh,
I just know she ate a lot in the studio.
Oh,
and,
well, does that all the time. But
would leave crumbs like crazy.
Yeah. She's nice enough.
All right. I've got a couple other articles that have pictures.
Ben,
The one that's not so needed, the picture, first. Kraft is releasing a salad frosting for kids.
I heard about this. Actually, I didn't hear about it. Yeah, I saw
Look
that.
At the little packet. Yeah.
Is it just
Did
like...
Did you see the picture? She's got like...
Oh, that bitch missing a tooth, man.
No. She's got like lettuce or broccoli or something in her teeth.
What?
Yeah, that's what it is. Don't look at the other pictures.
I'm not.
On the next page.
That looks like one of my pubes.
That's gross. This girl's like 9.
Sugary frosting?
Or are they just trying to
old-blooded creeper. Like slip it in without kids knowing.
That's right, Wade.
Feels pretty good to have a bunch of little boys be super into me.
All right, so Kraft is releasing a new product called Salad Frosting. It's in a pouch and has lots of bright colors on the front. Obviously, that's going to draw kids' attention. I want that. Especially the word frosting.
Right.
And
right.
I mean, it could say salad tossing, but.
Oh, yeah. Sexy sex.
Yeah.
Hey, drink your beer, bro. Come on. You got another one right there you got to finish. Sorry. No, you got to open that one still.
Mm.
Oh, gosh.
But salad frosting is actually just...
ranch.
Oh!
Really?
Yeah. Just ranch dressing.
Okay, so they're just trying to hide it.
Yeah.
No.
By the way...
Ranch is the last salad dressing that you need to do that to. And you need to cover it up for your kids. Every kid loves ranch. Shut the fuck up.
I only like French.
Fuck off. I like ranch and French.
Oh, and Italian.
Ooh,
French and Italian.
There you go. I think Italian would be one to cover up as a frosting. But it doesn't look white like common.
No, it doesn't. It's not really it's more like just olive oil.
Not a very good consistency.
ranch dressing isn't that healthier than actual frosting when it comes to calories and fat.
That much healthier?
Yeah. It does have less sugar, though, and it motivates kids to eat vegetables. So maybe it's worth it.
Nope.
I don't see that one going far.
No. Just like you with Brittany.
It's true. It's a good one.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Okay, listen to this.
No, I'm tapped out.
You're checking out
now.
A 3-year-old's birthday party theme.
Oh, okay. What was it?
It was sodomy.
Sodomy
and Gomorrah. Was that a fake laugh at first and then turn into a real laugh halfway through?
It was all real.
A girl named Lucia
Pussyfish
in Monterey, Mexico, turned 3 last week.
3.
And the theme for her party was?
Puss.
Drum roll, please. Oh. The horror movie, The Nun.
Really?
Have you seen what The Nun looks like?
Yes, I have. I mean, that's great. That's great. They're starting the kid out young on horror movies.
3.
Yeah, that's great. Let's start with some good movies.
It included a nun pinata, a nun cake, and Lucia and her friends dressing as the nun.
Sure, this just wasn't a Catholic theme.
Instead of a nun cake, why don't we have some cake?
Good one.
Jesus.
Boo
is right.
Hey, boo boo.
Apparently, Lucia watched the movie at her grandma's. What?
Wow, what a horrible grandmother.
Seriously. And she didn't find it scary. She liked the nun and felt like the nun was protecting her. What?
Ew.
How horrible is this girl's life outside of this movie?
How is she even able to distinguish what life is at 3 years old?
Yeah. After one of her cousins tweeted a few pictures. Jeez, dude, that was loud as hell.
That was a Rolling Rock. Brought to you by Rolling Rock.
Yeah, that's right.
Extra pale.
Yeah, sponsored by manscaped.com. Go there and try the Lawnmower 2.0 and shave them pubes. Pussyfish.
It all started going viral. Jordan Peele responded. Even responded to the tweet with, quote, "Does she have a godfather?" I don't know what the fuck that means.
He wants to be your godfather because that's badass.
Oh, and because he's black.
Put that pot out.
Here is the pictures. It's so fucking creepy.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, she's dressed like the nun. Look at the cake.
The pinata is a good foot taller than she is.
Yeah.
And then, the cake is the actual...
It's got the actual nun's
face. And then it says Lucia.
Ugh.
And the girl's got black paint around her eyes. That's great.
I would not date her when she grows up.
That's great. I would date the piñata.
Yeah?
Yeah. Wouldn't have to listen to a bitch.
Oh, jeez.
Come on, give me a pic. Or give me a
story.
Why you always give me the one half pagers?
Oh, my God. You complain no matter how long
there's
the story is.
There's three stories on this page.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're going back to fucking 2000 here with this one here.
What?
Sunburn tattoos are the latest summer fad.
2000? That was a fad before?
Yeah. Like, my sisters used to tan all the time, like going to tanning beds during the summer.
Yeah.
And you put a little piece of paper or like whatever you want.
Just over the clit?
Yeah, just like literally just over the clit. And
yeah, it's great. Pussy tan.
Well, Ben, there is nothing funny about getting sunburned.
That's true.
Unless, of course.
Can you imagine getting whipped with a towel when you're sunburned?
Oh, God. I got sunburned over the weekend.
Really?
Yeah, I was mowing
How?
My lawn. Dude, I spent 5 fucking hours mowing my parents' lawn.
How big is the lawn?
It's like 2.5 acres.
Speaking of how big is your dad's dick?
It's big enough to make me
come.
Yeah.
Dad.
There is nothing funny about getting sunburned.
No, there's not.
Unless, of course, you mean to do so because you're too cheap to get a real tattoo. Sunburn tattoos are making a comeback. Okay, cool. Yeah. The trend that first.
And so is skin cancer.
The trend that first tried to happen in 2015 is heating up for the summer of 2019 season, and doctors are warning against it.
Well, of course. Well, they should be warning for it.
Now I get to treat you and get all this money.
Yeah, very true.
Yeah.
Very true. Well, man, it works like this.
Chernobyl.
People place stencils on exposed skin and head outside to soak up some rays. When that mission is complete, they removed the stencils to reveal semi-permanent designs in paler skin tones. Wow, Ben, you picked this story. It wasn't long before hashtag sunburnt tattoo posts were popping up on Twitter and Instagram.
Oh, dude.
Nice.
Okay.
What?
Speaking of... Wait, what was the hashtag?
Hashtag sunburn tattoo.
I have something to show you.
You have a sunburn tattoo of your own?
And then I will tell you what the hashtag that's going viral is after I show you. Are you ready for this?
Is it pounded poo?
Let me plug in the phone.
Okay.
I don't know if it's really needed, if the audio is needed, but...
No, it's not.
Basically, we just need your reaction to it.
Reaction coming in 3, 2, 1. He's like doing starting to do a backflip, and then his ass just goes into the camera. What is it? What are you doing?
Here's another one. Can you explain to people what's happening?
He's just running towards the camera, lifting his legs up like he's going to do a backflip, and then his ass literally goes into the camera.
These are all different people.
He runs out of a little door. Oh, it's all different people?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Drink your beer, Ben. Drink your beer. I'm going to make one of those.
You should.
Let's both do it.
And then you can use the hashtag that's trending, which is running butthole challenge. So basically, yeah, you...
I'm going to do one. Legit. I'll do one for next week.
You just come running into the room with... like shorts on or underwear on, and at the last minute you're doing a flip right at the phone screen and showing your butthole.
Yeah.
So
you want to do it too?
No, I do not want to
post them both on our Patreon.
I'm worried about breaking my phone or like
you're worried about
hurting myself.
Your butt breaking your phone as you jump on.
Actually, I don't really want
a bed.
Jump and have the phone go in my butthole.
It's a butt crack. Shut the fuck up. Next story.
Oh, it's my phone.
Teachers and principal disciplined.
Mm.
An Indiana school principal has been placed on administrative leave, and three teachers' jobs are in jeopardy after a student with autism was given an award for the most annoying male by his special education teacher. Jesus. Oh my God.
That is so wrong.
It's like horrible to laugh at, but...
Yeah, but...
I'm laughing at the teacher for doing that, not the kid. That's horrible.
I'm laughing at just how horrible and awkward that is.
Speaking of laughing at things that shouldn't be laughed at, last week the old, like, 73-year-old woman getting picked up by the Coast Guard.
Getting picked up by the Coast Guard.
In, like, they drop the line
down
to her, and it starts spinning the bed
for,
thing.
For, like, 3 minutes.
Yeah.
Conan did a bit on his show where it was so fucking stupid, but he addressed that it was stupid.
Yeah.
He does that from time to time. They showed the video clip, and then they said, oh, we have the grandma here now.
Right.
And it's just some lady that comes out, and she spins as she walks all the way across the stage and throws out another door. It was so fucking bad. And he just stands there deadpan and just goes, that was stupid.
Have you watched Conan Without Borders?
Yes.
Yeah,
it's
that.
Amazing.
I finished that up last week.
My girlfriend loves that. Like, she now appreciates the show more because of Without Borders, because she's like, okay, I understand what you mean about how good he is at improvising.
He's the best late night, I think.
Oh, yeah.
That there is. He's besides Jimmy Kimmel.
He's my favorite. To me, it would go Letterman, Conan, Kimmel.
Fuck Letterman.
Or, I mean, Conan, Letterman, Kimmel.
There we go.
Yeah.
Conan, Kimmel, not Letterman.
I still need to read
Seth Meyers.
Yeah.
Carson Daly.
I actually like Carson Daly's
Fuck
show.
Carson
Once
Daly.
It became a half
Fuck
hour
you.
Show. Jeez Louise.
Suck a dick, Justin.
So angry.
Drink your beer. I'm getting drunk by myself over here.
I'm buzzed.
I have to pee, Ben.
Well, then go pee. We'll take an intermission.
Suck a dick. Don't tell me how to live my life.
Dude, you are just off the rails.
I'm hard. That's why.
I
haven't gotten my rocks off in like years.
You know what we'll do right now?
What?
Intermission.
Gonna find my baby, gonna hold her tight, gonna grab some afternoon delight. My motto's always been, when it's right, why wait until the middle of a cold, dark night? When everything's a little clearer in the light of day. And we know the night is always gonna be there anyway. Thinking of you's working up my appetite. Looking forward to a little afternoon delight. Rubbing sticks and stones together make the sparks ignite. And the thought of loving you is getting so exciting. Sky rockets in flight.
Pew!
Afternoon delight.
Whoop.
You guys have it, I think.
Afternoon delight.
Do you have any more stories there, Bucko?
I do, yes.
Okay, good. Because I'm going to pull up this new.
I don't think I ever got through this one, but as I was going to the bathroom, Ben, I got to say, you better put a ring on that woman's finger.
Why?
Because every fucking time I come over here.
Your boobs?
I wish. Every time I come over here, it smells so fucking good. Whatever she's cooking.
She is a great cook.
She's a great cook, and I've never had her food. Maybe one day you'll invite me over
for
dinner.
I eat her food and eat her puss. Pussy fish.
Don't talk about my future wife like that.
Mm. It's my future wife. My wife. My wife.
I don't think we ever got into the teachers and principal being disciplined, did we?
I think I read the... You the said first. That
oh, yeah,
they made fun of a kid with autism?
Yeah.
He was annoying.
Most annoying male by a special education teacher.
That like one of those mock like award things?
Yeah.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Can you imagine that? Like, oh, like most funny or most likely to become a celebrity. And then you see most annoying and your son with autism.
Yeah.
And his picture is
and
there.
His teacher is the one that.
Ugly.
Anyways, the principal of Ballet Preparatory Academy.
Yeah.
Was placed on leave, and three teachers were served with preliminary determination notice of contract cancellation as a result of the award, which stunned the boys' parents. Estella and Rick Castillon said their son's Achilles received the award along...
Achilles?
Yeah.
You know what his Achilles heel is? His autism.
Oh, God, Ben.
Put that part out.
Yeah. Received the award along with one other student during a fifth grade event on May 23rd.
he voiced their son. They also they said their son was embarrassed by the award. The family says they plan on moving to another school district before classes begin next year. The school issued a statement that said an investigation resulted in three teachers being served preliminary determination notice of contract cancellation. The school's principal has been placed on administrative leave pending an additional investigation. God, Ben. One more. I got one more story for you.
Okay.
Hit me.
Are you all right? You get.
I missed the whole second half of that story.
Yeah, so did I, and I was reading it. A woman mistakes emergency door on plane for bathroom.
Oh, no.
Oh, God. All right. A flight from Manchester was delayed 7 fucking hours after a passenger mistakenly opened an emergency exit instead of the toilet door. Let me tell you, to open the emergency exit, it's a task.
That's what I would figure.
It's a big fucking like lever that you have to open, and the bathroom is like you push a little button.
Yeah, exactly.
Open. It happened aboard. This makes sense. It happened aboard a Pakistan International Airlines flight.
9/11 was an inside job.
The flight as a female passenger accidentally opened the emergency exit door, thinking there was a toilet on the other side. Nope, just the world. Thankfully, the flight was still on the runway in Manchester and not in the air. She was mistakenly, as she mistakenly opened the aircraft's left rear door, it automatically the aircraft's emergency chute. The mistake caused a nearly 8-hour delay to the 7-hour 50-minute flight. This was due to a crew needing to reseat 21 of the 393 passengers.
Holy shit.
And offload 35 because the rear exit door was no longer available for use in the event of an emergency.
That's what my girlfriend says.
What?
The rear is exit only.
Oh, damn. There you go, Ben. That's a joke.
Ah.
Use that one.
No, that's no. I can't
make an
do
airplane
that.
Joke and then.
I've got like 5.5 minutes that I'm proud of.
Well, I wouldn't be proud.
Speaking
of
that, I need people to come on July 7th.
Oh my god, this is that.
No,
part,
seriously,
this is the part of the podcast where you skip forward like 40 minutes.
July 7th.
I'll be at the Garage Bar and Grill May 31st, 9:00. Come vote for me.
July 7th. It's really
July 7th.
It's a quote unquote bringer show.
What the fuck?
You have to bring people, otherwise terrible people get voted on to the next round.
Ben, you need more friends.
Because of their friends and family.
You have horrible friends.
I know. Nobody votes for
me. Nobody even invites you to be in their wedding.
Oh, damn it. That's right. I cut that part out.
Did you really?
I did. Because I didn't want to make anybody mad. But in case you didn't know, for those since I did cut it out,
since I'm gonna cut it out again this episode.
No, I won't cut it out this time. So there's a group of 5 of us that have been friends since high school, and we're all super close. We've stayed super close.
Yeah, like they masturbate each other.
Yeah, that's right.
Great story.
Ah,
masturbating.
They've all been married. I'm the only one that hasn't been married. They've all been in each other's wedding parties.
Obviously.
The last one.
You weren't even fucking an usher.
The other 4 people. Well, one was getting married. Uh-huh. One was a best man. The other 2 were groomsmen. And I was just invited.
Good for you. Maybe they just don't trust you with responsibility.
I asked one of my friends after I got a good buzz on. I was like, how big of a piece of shit do you guys think I am?
Yeah.
And because he had one more groomsman besides the ones I mentioned.
Yeah.
And it's like, why wasn't that me? I've known him since 3rd grade. Like,
right. And then he's like, I'm going to walk away from this conversation.
Yeah.
That's all right. Like I said, you'll be in my wedding, Ben.
Oh, this is awkward.
Well, thank you.
Just got to find the one first. Or anyone, really.
Brittany.
Andy.
Miss Michigan.
Pretty cool.
Lori Palmer?
Nah. I don't know who that is.
That's your left hand.
Oh. Well, Miss Michigan is... That's pretty cool. Seriously. You know that, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Do you know what I'm... Are you joking with me? Jackie is Miss Michigan.
Yeah, and she's pretty cool.
Okay.
Catcher from 10 to 3?
Catch me outside.
How about that? What time is she on like Hot FM? 3 to 7?
3 to 7,
I think. And is she on that new station that's different?
I don't think so. No,
quote unquote, it's different here? So.
Nope. That's okay, though.
Fucking terrible.
Well, I'm on Twitter at TheBrettHayes.
I'm glad we got dropped for stations that are losing ratings like crazy.
Yeah, seriously.
Just going in the shit.
It's ridiculous, man.
I wish I could like just laugh.
They're firing the whole traffic department.
I heard.
Yeah.
That's fucking insane.
Outsourcing or technological advancements. I don't know.
How?
It's... I don't
Radio
know.
Sucks. Radio is dead.
That's why I'm happy that Bill and I aren't
a part of that
super
company.
Super affiliated with Cumulus, yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's not good.
Everything, they're getting rid of just all their people, actual people.
They are. They're trying to save money. I think they're trying to make it look good so they can be sold eventually.
Here, seriously?
Coming up, yeah.
Well, then maybe they'll hire me back, the new company.
I think that somebody needs to get fired.
I mean, how are they letting all these like actual physical people go when iHeart has like $20 billion in debt, where we only had $2 billion before bankruptcy? You know what I mean?
Well, some companies care about their employees. Some don't.
Yeah, that's true.
That's why I loved working at Town Square. Like, I don't have...
Oh, dude!
I don't have the relationships with people at Cumulus that I do that I did at Town Square.
Oh, I do.
Like it was fun at Town Square. I don't.
I had a rough time at Town Square.
Well, I didn't have a rough time
with two people,
Tom and Jana.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Whereas, like with everybody else, Andy, JoJo.
Yeah.
The best was when Metalhead Ned was working there, and he was our boss.
Yeah, he was cool. You guys can have one beer.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Nobody else would let us have anything. No. But it was
we were there with JoJo once.
That was like,
we?
That's
two?
What it was.
Oh, yeah. It was
at that home bar in
yep.
the Bob.
Bob.
And JoJo went and got a beer. And we were like, I guess it's okay to go get a beer.
Yeah, we are literally walking across the parking lot to take our stuff back.
And no, it's not okay for us to have a beer, but it's okay for the talent to have a beer. There's a big difference.
Well, because we were in charge of the vehicle, the station vehicle, but
we didn't
there,
have a vehicle.
Yeah,
we're at the Bob.
At that point, we didn't have to drive a vehicle.
Have you seen the radio station now? Like the buildings?
Yeah. I parked right next to them.
It looks so strange.
It looks very different. I texted
and now,
Greg last week, and I want to see the new studio.
Yeah, I would love to do that, too.
Yeah. Maybe we can go in, like, in the next month when they're done with it.
Oh, I wanted to get to this, where... This story where this comes from.
Black people are idiots.
God. All right.
President's office confirms the authenticity of text messages in which his chief of staff brags about his use of illegal drugs.
Included is a text where Cade Cawthron brags about snorting cocaine inside his legislative office. And now we've also uncovered other texts where both men speak of women in vulgar terms.
Ooh. Now, all of this comes days after News Channel 5 uncovered racist text messages from the chief of staff. Our chief investigative reporter,
dude,
Phil
so
Williams,
great.
Has another News Channel 5 investigation.
He actually uses the N-word. Doesn't
they
bleep
the
it out?
The latest text messages were sent back in 2015 and 2016 when Cade Cawthron was press secretary for the Tennessee House
it
Republican
sounds like
caucus.
A computer.
They're part of the same batch of text messages from a former acquaintance that the
acquaintance.
House last week has suggested were bogus.
Bogus.
He sounds like
a motion to reconsider
his
is
nose
table.
Is stuffed.
On Thursday, it was business as usual.
It sounds like he's got cum in his throat.
Representatives, just hours after News Channel 5 investigates, revealed the existence.
House of Representatives.
Play that part again, can you?
News Channel 5. News Channel 5 investigates. News Channel 5 investigates.
Of racist text messages sent by the House Speaker's chief of staff, Cade Cawthron.
My chief of staff is up here. He's up here working. He did nothing wrong.
Among Cawthron's text messages, there was this 2015 text, "Black people are idiots." And another, he insisted on using thug N-word to describe Tampa Bay quarterback
Jameis
Winston.
Okay, so here he's reading the text
and he says thug N-word. Thug Wait N-word. Till you hear him actually confront the guy in person.
Oh, God.
In a 2016 exchange with Cassidy himself, Catherine responded with this black people meme, apparently referring to a West Tennessee district. The House Speaker
claimed a picture of Sam Jackson, and it said black people.
Again, kind of verifies in my mind there's something not right about that story.
It was a theme Cassidy continued on talk radio.
In this environment what the that we fuck? Live in because he's,
that guy's backing him up still.
Battle,
well,
I'm convinced
taking out of context.
Liberal,
no.
Guy living with his mom and dad.
I don't even care about the story. I'm wondering how this broadcaster is even in the business.
But the text
he won an Emmy.
Also included this selfie that
he won an Emmy?
Yeah.
How?
I think for this story.
Masturbate. Texted, tripping balls out of my mind at
oh, wait. Oh,
15.
This is
craziest experience.
This is where they start talking about you.
Dean trip to the Dominican Republic. Catherine also texted, just did a gram of cocaine. Oh.
No. Winning the intellectual battle.
Sorry,
I'm convinced some
liberal, fast forward instead of rewinding.
Living with his mom and dad in their basement created this to frame my chief of staff.
I think this is where it starts talking about you.
Also included this selfie that Catherine had taken at 2:15 a.m.
Catherine?
During a trip to Colorado.
Here comes.
He texted, "Tripping balls out of my mind at 2:15. Craziest experience of my entire life. Acid, cocaine, weed." He also shared this.
That's going to be you after your Seattle trip.
Oh, I just got a great idea.
Ripping balls out of
when
my
I do shrooms, when and if, I should call you and we should have a conversation on the phone.
Yeah, boy.
And record it.
Okay.
That week.
Video from a concert at the Red Rocks Amphitheater. And
Amphitheater.
$40 After a 2015 trip to the Dominican Republic, Catherine also texted, just did a gram of cocaine in my office.
Who doesn't?
It was sent at 10:38 a.m. Yeah, on a
work day. You ever done cocaine, man?
You refer to Jameis Winston as a thug. How can you justify after it?
See? He actually says the word when he's confronting him.
Oh, God.
During our previous questions about his racist text messages, Catherine responded this time with a written statement. Regarding the text in question, I readily admit that I said some of them. While I'm not proud of who I was in the past, I am proud that with God's grace and a strong support system, I've been able to achieve so much in the years since.
Without objection, so ordered. Next order, Ms. Clark.
Did he just take all of his voiceover work and slow it down?
I don't know.
Welfare recipients who tested positive. Positive for drugs.
Who takes positive
the case of Catherine, who makes $200,000 a year.
$200,000 a year.
Politics has become a game of gotcha with no thought of forgiveness and starting.
How did this guy win an Emmy?
I choose to believe
are you
that
fully?
We all
you're
deserve
fucking with me, are you?
Redemption.
Mm-hmm. You're not.
You think that black people are idiots?
But it wasn't just comments about minorities. We also obtained
minorities.
Solicited sexual favors from legislative interns and suggested sex with a female lobbyist who was older than him. I want you to be my first older woman, he texted.
Ooh.
In one case in 2016, Catherine texted this pic of a female friend pole dancing to Cassidy. The House Speaker responded, Cassidy. Nice pics. Catherine,
nice
hands to yourself. The speaker, can I just touch? Catherine, LOL, okay, maybe just once. The speaker, LOL.
L-O-L.
Great news.
Of course,
reporting.
This follows a legislative session.
Oh, my God. That's almost as bad as us.
All right. I've got two more. Let's do two more things.
Okay.
And then we'll get out of here.
Sans geek.
Next, let's just do one more thing.
Hey.
This one's a good thing. Oh, you want to read it?
Yeah, I want to read it.
All right. This one's really good.
Okay.
It makes me jealous that we're
interesting.
Not living in this state, but we're actually living in Michigan. Because this state is doing something right.
This state, referring to this article, the top new West Virginia tourism slogans.
Yeah, I thought this was BS. Like, the prep service was just being funny and making jokes.
Uh-huh.
But no.
Are you using the prep service that we used?
Yeah.
Oh, delicious.
Yeah, same thing that...
You're still logged in as Michelle McCormick?
I am.
Okay, me too.
Same thing as, like, Freebird and Hot Wings use it.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah. That's cool.
We get some good stories from it.
Yeah, we do.
That's where this one came from.
Some. Anyways, Wallet Hub named West Michigan. Named West Virginia the least... Okay, the least fun state...
state in the U.S. And yeah. The state's tourism people are said to be working on changing that with a new marketing campaign.
Yeah, so West Virginia's actual state, what was it, representatives?
Yeah. Are their marketing campaign.
Okay, yeah. They are the ones that came up with these slogans.
So they're trying to come up with new slogans that make West Virginia more interesting.
And boy, did they.
They got some doozies here.
Yes, they do.
Right. I'll read the first three, Ben, and then I'll let you do the next three.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah?
There's a lot there.
Exactly. West Virginia, because you have to stop somewhere on your way to Florida. I like that. It's true.
Not
it's
the
true.
Strongest one.
No, not the strongest. Next. So terrible, they didn't even bother trying for an East Virginia.
Shit. That's a shit one.
Yeah, that is bad. Next. Why watch Game of Thrones when you can experience incest, violence, and a lack of electricity in person?
That's a good
10
one.
10 out of 10 for that.
God, that one made me actually laugh out loud when I read it.
Yes. LOL.
West Virginia, where tattoos outnumber teeth almost 2-1. Justin. What happens here stays here. Or at least it would if anything ever happened here. West Virginia, now with more indoor plumbing.
Next one. Where else can you find whiskey that'll also run your car in a pinch?
Or make your dick not work.
Ah, very true. Here we go.
Jameson.
We are the mountain state. Unfortunately, it's mostly family that we're mountain. Oh, God.
Applause to that one.
Are they? Really? That is their marketing campaign? Like, legit? Thank you.
Take a bow. Well, take a bow.
I'm not going to thank you. It's the marketing campaign that needs. Okay. Oh, God. West Virginia is for lovers of watching paint dry. That was 100% real.
I'm surprised it wasn't West Virginia's for lovers of family members.
Yeah, that too.
All right. Ooh, West Virginia, where Limp Bizkit and cargo shorts never went out of style.
I thought my jokes were bad.
West Virginia, because alcohol is meant to be made in your backyard. Yeah. Sucks. West Virginia, home to,
Did you say something?
We'll get back to you on that. West Virginia, where your daughter and your wife can be the same person.
Okay, cool.
That's a strong one.
I don't know about that one. We've got all your favorite rodents served a fresh daily.
Oh. Yeah, this is turning into a stinkers. This is not finishing the podcast out strong I thought.
Not as strong as my dick. It's like visiting a third world country without ever leaving America. Okay, that one's all right.
I mean, not funny.
Ooh, this one's good. West Virginia, we don't meth around. Mm. Get it? Like meth?
That's bunny.
Final one is, we just got cable.
Great story.
Well, Ben, way to put a damper on life.
Yeah. Sorry, everybody. Way to disappoint. Maybe I can turn things around with my story? Let's finish this.
All right. I'm at the Brett Hayes, HAZEBRETTHETHEBRETTHAZE.
I got so confused.
At THE.
Restart.
I'm at the Brett Hayes, BRETTHAZE.
What about the THE?
Oh.
Not the THC, but the THE.
I'm at the Brett Hayes, THEBRETTHAZE.
Yay! And I'm at the Ben Glaze, THEBENGLAZE.
Puss.
We're on patreon.com/glazeandhaze and reddit.com/r/glazeandhaze. Put July 7th on your calendars, folks. Please. Please.
I'll be there.
The first 100 people in the door get ballots to vote.
That's all you had to say. I'm there for free shit.
And the top three people move on to the next round. The host from Dr. Grin's, Garrett, didn't get passed because he didn't bring anybody.
No, he's not funny.
No, that's not true at all.
Probably pretty true.
If you would have went and saw Pete Lee this week and you'd been like, oh, fuck, that Garrett's funny.
Probably not. So this is more of a popularity contest. So like who has the most friends?
It's just a bringer show.
So it's not, let's not vote for the funniest person. Let's vote for whoever.
Same thing happened at funniest person in Grand Rapids.
That's rigged. And I'm going to have to say something to Garrett about that.
No, don't say something to him. Say something to Sunday Night Funnies. No, Seth is gone.
Seth's a bitch.
Seth died.
Just like Justin. No, good.
I'm just kidding.
Hopefully he can take Justin with him.
Oh my
God. Boom. Death. Pervert.
All righty.
Hey.
I don't even know if I should reference what just happened.
No.
No.
Do you want to go to the LPGA this week?
The LGBTQ?
No, the Lesbian Pro Golfers Association.
What?
You want to go to that? I got tickets.
When is it?
It's like all week till Saturday.
Do they scissor?
Yeah, I'm going to try to go to the Grand Taste on Friday or Saturday.
Do they throw away the clubs and the balls and then just fuck each other?
Oh, they use the balls and the clubs for dildos.
Oh, they might use the balls as like Benoit balls.
Benoit.
They strengthen their vagina muscles. Let's talk like golf announcers.
We'll catch you next week, guys.
All right. He's putting now. Trying to go for birdie. This one will win it all.
You can see his dick lining the edge of his pants.
If you don't remember, speaking of golf clubs, Tiger had one put through his window by his wife. Oh. Perkins waitress.
Nice reference.
I don't know what else to talk about, but we're going to get out of here.
Adjective describes it now.
Well, that's true.
All right. I'm going to go, too, because I got to pee.
I was so horny that I masturbated my friend.
masturbated.
All right, guys. We'll see you next week.
Hi, Mom. Say your signature sign-off.
Oh, bye, fuckers.
Goodbye.
No, bye, fuckers.
Goodbye.
I have to be the last one that says bye, fuckers.
Goodbye.
Bye, fuckers. Bye, fuckers.
Bye.
Bye, fuckers.
I'll see you later. Talk to you later, everybody.
Don't ruin my outro.
We'll say it again.
Bye, fuckers.
I'm going to keep talking. So you got to keep staying. Do it one more time. Do it one more time. Make me happy. Give me hard.
Bye, fuckers.
Oh boy.
That's awesome.